COSASE entered day two of its inquiry into the Uganda National Bureau of Standards, UNBS. The executive director, David Livingstone Ebiru, made a shocking revelation that he bribed the entity's board with 100 million shillings to prevent the termination of his contract of service after the IGG and the Minister of Trade, Francis Mwebesa, wrote recommendations to the board for his termination. Seated close to the board chairperson, Charles Mosekura, Ebiru accused his boss for soliciting for this bribe after receiving the two recommendations to sack him. Ebiru noted that he was left with no choice but to give a bribe to save his job.
Ebiru, are you confirming to this committee that you bribed board members with 100 million shillings?
I was asked through by the chair that I must do the needful to cool down what is going on.
And you gave them 100 million shillings?
Yes, sir.
Where did you get the 100 million shillings from?
I borrowed the money.
So this was personal money?
Yes, sir.
And you handed it over to who?
Through the representative of the chairman, one of the board members here,
Mr. Omar.
He came to my office and picked it from my office.
Was it cash? It was in what?
Cash.
Cash. In a bag? In what exactly?
In a bag.
Okay, so just to understand again properly, so you're saying you borrowed this money? And you're giving it to them for what? To cool down what exactly? Let's understand that. And when was this, by the way?
That detail can be got. To write that letter back to IGG required that. So you saw the letter, he says he cannot trace. So that letter was a ransom.
Ebiru's admission followed documents laid before Parliament by the board chairperson, including a thread of WhatsApp conversations which the executive director had with one board member, inquiring whether he had received a share on the 100 million shillings he had sent to them.
This is the ED writing to a board member here. The board member is here today. Ndugu, take interest in those engagements regarding funding to the Bureau, which I'm being accused of misappropriating funds at source. Then the board member says, all right, brother.
So according to this, David Ebiru, the ED, is one who was writing this and talking about the 100 million shillings, and Robert Mwanje was responding.
However, Omar Mohammadi, one of the board members who Ebiru accuses of picking the money from his office, and Mosekura dismissed these accusations.
It's from Mr. Ebiru.
Definitely not, Mr. Chairman. The first time I came into contact with that information was from a gentleman called Ronald, who works from the Ministry of Trade. He's in internal security, who brought it to my attention via a WhatsApp. In fact, I'm looking for the WhatsApp now, who told me, you have to watch out. The ED is spoiling your name.
While we all like money, his love for money is legendary.
Relatedly, COSASE grilled Ebiru over failure to take action against UNBS staff who caused a financial loss to the Bureau of 9.28 billion shillings. The five staff, including Raymond Odiokol, Rogers Juko, Emmanuel Mwanguzi, Emmanuel Atet, and Bosco Luima, were implicated for backdating inspection debts on inspection reports and editing application debts on the e-portal applications, which resulted into a loss of 9.28 billion shillings to the Bureau. The management recommended to the executive director to take action against the implicated staff, but Ebiru instead let them off the hook.
Members culpable for the 9.28 billion shillings loss. That was your statement, and that's the exact word you used. You found them culpable.
I did not expect to have been blamed to have taken possibly a contrary position when it was not very clear. So I thought that had empowered me to evaluate. As I told you, I look at the past history where six staff were ordered back to the institution, and the institution had to pay heavily.
The committee discovered that the ED never sought legal advice from the Director of Legal Services, but went on to conclude the matter by himself.
The ED, you are a disgrace to this country. You are an embarrassment to this country. Because 9.6 billion People have stolen, there's an internal report on to that, confirming that these people have stolen the money. You call for a meeting and you sit as an individual and you decide to keep these people around simply because you are protecting the image of the organization when people have stolen money. His advice was, look, if we are saying we do not tolerate corruption at all, let's take these people to court. Let's prosecute them. Do you remember that advice from your head legal?
Chair, it is not a good practice to disagree with your juniors here, but minutes have been shared and that advice is not documented in those minutes.
With all these revelations powering in, the committee chairperson, Joel Senyonyi, was left with no action but to hand over a bureau to police for further action.
The report to the minister.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.